Hi, welcome to an NX 12 video tutorial. Now, the second place went to Siemens NX. So, I will do the soccer ball or foosball in Siemens NX 12. So, let's have some fun with Siemens NX. At first, I will go for an Icosa IDA. So let's start with a sketch on maybe the YZ plane. But I need an expression, so go for tools, expressions, and call this one side length. And the value should be 60. Okay. Now let's go for our polygon, and in NX that's very useful, you can do any polygon. I want to go for 5 sides. The length should be the side length. Okay. And the rotation should be 90 degrees, so I just need a point, so go for that point and close that one. Nice, finish that sketch. Now for another sketch, maybe on the ZX plane. I need that point in my sketch, so I go for intersection point. Okay, now put a circle on that point, and the diameter should be 2 times the side length, so it's 2 times side length, and okay. Close this one. That circle should be only for construction. No, I don't want that one. I wanted this to be for construction. Okay, then I need a point. That point should be on the circle, and it should also be, I need that point on that axis. Finish that sketch. Now I can go for 3D lines, or at least one. Go for curve, line, from point to point, so select the point and that point as well, and okay. Now in NX I can pattern that line. This wasn't possible in CATIA, so I go for a pattern. Home, more pattern geometry. Nice. Circular, yes, the vector would be the x-axis, and I need 5 instances, count and span. 5 is the count, span is 360 degrees, and okay, very nice. And in the NX I can use these lines, and I don't need surfaces. But I need another circle, so we'll go for a 3D circle. Go for curve, go for an arc circle, a 3-point arc, yes, and that should be through this point, and that end point. Seems I got the wrong points, so try once more. go for an arc. It would be this point. Yes. And then the end point, sorry. Like this. Okay, and then that point. Okay. Let's go for a full arc, a full circle, and okay. Now I could define my axis, which will go from this point to the center of that circle. And okay. Now I can pattern again one line with this one. So go for another pattern, more pattern geometry, and I want only a single curve, not infill curves, but single curve, and I want to pattern, for example, that line. Vector would be this line. In this case I need only three or two, one, two, I need only two, and I go for count and pitch, and that would be 360 divided by 5, and it should be the other way around, and I need 3, yeah, and okay. Very, very nice. Now another circle through points, circle. A 3-point circle. Sorry, that's the sketch circle. Go to curve, arc circle, 3-point arc, start point, end point, and that one up here. Okay. And confirm. Now again I could define an axis line from this point up here to the center of that circle. And okay. Now another pattern. More pattern geometry. Again a single curve, yes. In this case maybe that one. Vector would be that line. In that direction, 72, count and pitch 3, is the count, and confirm. Now I could hide that arc and hide that other arc as well. So let's draw some lines from this point to that point. Apply from this point to that one. Apply point, point. Apply, and over here as well, point, point, apply, point, point, apply, and what's missing? Okay, point. Point, apply, and that one from this point over there, and okay. Okay, I don't need all of those lines. These are too many. I want to delete this one. And then I will lose another one, but that's no problem. I will just attach one more. And okay. And I don't need this one, but that belongs to that pattern. So go to the pattern and just delete that instance and confirm. That's more like it. And if I do a circular pattern with this one, I will get, of course, an icosaeda. I could hide that line and this one. And the rotation axis would be a line from the center of this one to the center of that one. Okay. And if I do now a pattern, so go for a selection filter, go only for curves, select all those curves, deselect that one, and go for home, more pattern geometry, and the axis would be that line, and I need two, count and span, 360 degrees. Yeah. So now I got my icosaeda. This concludes the first part of that foosball in Siemens NX. Hope you enjoyed it. If you liked it, please give it a like or leave a comment. If you want to see more, please give it a like or leave a comment. Please subscribe to my YouTube channel and please subscribe to my Facebook Cat fan page and please like it. Would be very nice of you. Thanks for watching. See you to next one, which will be the second part of the soccer ball or foosball. Bye bye.